Today, I developed the story about the lives and sorrows of royal concubines of the Joseon Dynasty who lived in fierce competition for survival. It seems like the royal concubines will wear makeup every day and wait for a king, but it's a drama story. They prepared ancestral lives and the reception for guests according to their title. The royal concubines under the Changsa Pum had to work, such as preparing beds for the king and queen. And the king could not interfere recklessly because the court late management was under the jurisdiction of the queen. They followed the queen's instruction better than the king. The royal concubines is divided to Gantaek concubine and the Seungeun concubine, and the outward appearance of Gantaek concubines was not very important. This is because the court administrator mainly saw the body and the character that are likely to give birth to children well as children of noblemen. Instead, Gantaek concubine immediately was given the title of a class of Sugui. The Seungeun concubine was mainly court lady and became a concubine after being noticed by the king, so it started with a special concubine. She was given the title of Sugwon. When a court lady makes a love with the king overnight, she becomes a special concubine, followed by Sugwon, Sowon, Sukyeong, Soyeong, Sukwi, Sowi, Gyuin, and Bin. The queen has no title. As a company, it can be called clerk, assistant manager, manager, vice president, managing director, executive vice president. There are a lot of companies that don't have that system these days. Anyway, the title of Bin was Jeong Il-pum as the prime minister, so powerful. In order to distinguish between several Bins, they were called Suk Bin and He Bin by adding letters such as good-looking Suk, blessing He, and shining He, which symbolized different women. The court lady who slept with the king had a private residence away from the housework, but if the king died, the concubines came out of the palace and lived with their children. If they had without children, they went out and became female monks and died living a lonely life while praying for the king's heavenly bliss. Of course, even if the concubine had a lot of children, there was a low rank, and even the king had a favor, the position of concubine was meaningless. Kim Ge-si, a sneaky girl in the Gwanghae-gun era, was a court lady for her lifetime. Jang Rok-su, who enjoyed all the power of Yeonsan-gun, was a Sukwon. Jang Rok-su's face was below normal, but it was said to have been excellent in singing and dancing. All the same, the beauty could be abandoned, but if she's good at food, she could not be mistreated. There's a saying that being pretty won't last for 3 years. It is said that if you are good at cooking, it will last forever. Bin Gyuin graveyard. After dying, Bin and Sugi are all the same. Bin and Gyuin graveyard are the places where 16 tombs of royal concubines of the Joseon and the Korean empires were moved after Japanese colonial era and liberation. Each tomb has a stone table and a tombstone, all in one bent wall, and the rest of stones are not handed down. Sugui graveyard. It's like a cemetery because it's gathered in one place in Japanese colonial era. Each tomb has a stone table and a tombstone, and on the back of some tombstones, there are traces of deleting the Japanese age. All of them are in one bent wall, and the rest of the stones are not handed down. In the tomb of the royal concubines, the tomb of the deposed Yun clan, the tomb of the prince and the princess, and the placenta chamber are in the same area. The tomb of Bin and Gyuin is a graveyard, built by collecting 16 royal concubine tombs of the Joseon Dynasty and the Korean Empire. Thank you. Sugu's tombs were built by collecting five concubines of the king of Joseon and one tomb of King Wanqin, the son of King Gosong's royal concubine Lee.